What's going on, guys? In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you a very profitable side hustle known as flipping cars and how I made over $100,000 net profit in a span of 2 years at the age of 15 and a half years old and how you can do exactly that. Now, I'm also going to be sharing with you guys my strategy of how I did it and how you can do it today. Now, here's the backstory and how I got into flipping cars. And remember, if you get any value from this video, don't forget to hit the like button. Now, I began flipping electronics at the age of 12 years old, guys. I was in seventh grade. I had people who were selling me electronics and I was also buying them. So I would buy it at a lower price and then I would flip it for a higher price. And I kept on saving and saving and saving and saving until I had enough money. I was 15 years old or 15 and a half years old. And I decided I now want to buy myself a personal car, a car that I can drive around because I had my permit. Now, after flipping electronics, I had exactly $6,800 saved. I started at 12 years old and I stopped about 15 and a half years old when I decided I want to buy my first car. Now, on the side, I was still flipping electronics, but then I decided throughout that, let me buy myself my first car. Now, I had $6,800. My family advised me to not splurge and to not buy the nicest car. And for us, we're middle class, a little bit less than middle class family. Parents are both school teachers. So for us, splurging was $6,800 on a car. I think that at that moment when I was looking to shop for a car, trying to spend all that money, I was the one who had the nicest car in the entire family at that moment. So my parents were like, don't splurge. And my family was like, just take it easy. Buy a nice car that's for a couple thousand. Don't spend all your money and take it slow. It's your first car. Now I started looking, what car do I personally want? I started doing research and I started looking all over and I decided that I want an Infiniti G35 Coupe. It was within the price range. You can find some for a couple thousand, 5,000, 6,000, 7,000, but they'd be beat up. If I wanted a nice one, I had to spend $9,000, $10,000. But I knew I wanted that and I knew that I'm gonna be able to find one that's below market and for a good price, so I started searching. Now I ended up finding a 2005 Infiniti G35 Coupe and my mind was blown. It was listed on Craigslist for $7,800. I was so excited. I was short $1,000 because I only had $6,800, but I knew I was gonna make a deal work. I knew that I can find a way to negotiate the price, so I went quickly, told my dad, and told him we gotta go see this car, and I scheduled an appointment. Now, it's important to remember, guys, I was 15 and a half, and I still had my permit. I didn't even have my license yet, but I was hyped, and I wanted that car. Now, I only had $6,800. The guy was asking $7,800. I went to my dad, told him, let's get going, but I did tell my dad to bring $500 with him in case I needed it, and I told him that I had that money in the bank, but I didn't have enough time to go get it. Reality was, I never had that extra money, and if I had to use that $500 to make the deal work, I was gonna figure it out later. Deep down, I knew that $6,800 was gonna be a tough number to get, but I felt like if I had an extra $500, $7,300 would have made it work, so I convinced my dad to bring the extra $500, and he assumed that I had that money that I would have gave him after the deal closed. Now, when I got there, guys, I absolutely fell in love. This car was gorgeous. I said, there's no way I'm leaving unless I buy this car. It was gray exterior, tan interior, black 19-inch rims, black tinted tail lights, 280 horsepower, 270 pound-foot of torque. It was a beauty. Now, that horsepower back then at 15 and a half years old, that was power. Right now, I'm looking at 600-700 horsepower and I'm like, eh, it's not much, but I was in love with this car. Now, guys, I want you to keep something in mind. When I saw this car and it was in mint condition, meaning there was nothing wrong, that's a problem, because I was trying to negotiate it down from $7,800 to $6,800, which is all I had. I wasn't trying to use the $500 my dad assumed I was gonna give him back if he lent it to me. So when I got there, I loved the car, but at the same time, when I was about to get started to negotiate, I was like, crap, what am I gonna tell him? Now, these Infinities are known for their leather seats on the side of them to start ripping. So this one had it. It was very minor, but it had it. That was something I can grab on. The radio, it wasn't working too clear. That was something I was grabbing on. But overall, there wasn't much I can negotiate or justify negotiating $1,000 off. So then what I did is I mentioned these problems to the seller, and then I kind of threw the problem on my dad. I was like, look, my dad doesn't even want me to have this car. if he finds out the price on this car, he's gonna kill me and we're not gonna be buying it. Even though it's my money, he's still gonna have a big impact on me with this purchase. So I was like, look, if it's $6,800, I can justify to my dad that it makes sense and that I can make money on it, even though I plan to keep it, and overall it would be a lot easier. So I told him the points on the car of what's wrong with it. I justified the problem onto my dad. And then I told him, look, I got $6,800 cash right now. You're gonna have no headache, no having to meet someone else and try to sell it. And then I started to walk away. When I started to walk away, I was walking around the car. I didn't tell him that and just leave. I started to just walk around the car, letting him kind of soak in what I just said. And then after a couple of minutes, I walked to the car, grabbed the cash as if he accepted the deal. Now I walked back to him with the cash. I told him, hey, look, I'm 15 and a half years old. This is gonna be my first car. I gave him a little bit of a sob story. And I was like, imagine this was you at 15 and a half buying this car. I'm sure you fell in love with it when you purchased it. So come on, it's just $1,000. And guys, he ended up accepting it for $6,800, and my mind was blown. I was so flipping happy, I couldn't even believe it. In fact, my dad assumed that I was gonna tow the car back or someone else was gonna bring the car back because I didn't have my license, I had my permit. But what did I do? I hopped in the front and I started to drive, and my dad started to follow me home even though I only had my permit. Now fast forward, guys, that's the story of how I bought my first car. Now I bought this as a personal car. I didn't intend to flip it, but I got it for such a good price. So here's what I did. I said, look, you got it for a good price, Karam. List it on the market for $10,000 and just see what happens. I went online, I listed it, put beautiful pictures, and I said, let me see what happens if I get an offer. And if I get a good offer that I can't resist, I may just sell it. About 1 week later, I'm boarding a flight to Australia, Sydney, Australia, and I'm literally handing my passport, about to go into the airplane, my passport and my ticket, and I get a phone call. And this phone call is someone who's interested in the car, saying, I'm gonna fly down there, I'm gonna bring my daughter with me, and we're interested, I wanna gift it to her for her graduation. Now, I'm not knowing if I should be happy or if I should be sad or what, but I hang up the phone, I call my brother, I give numbers to each other so they can coordinate, and I board the flight. So now when I got onto the airplane, I honestly started to make prayers that the car does not sell. I didn't want to sell it. I only had it for a couple of days. Even though the profit was so good, I had an attachment to it. It's not easy to find a mint car, a car that's real good condition and taken care of, especially for a personal use, for that good price. And overall, I just didn't want to sell it, but I did what I had to do. I gave my brother the information, the title, all that was ready. And then I said, let's see what happens. 18 hours later, which I believe the flight was 18 hours, I landed in Sydney, Australia. My phone had text messages, voicemails, phone calls, and I opened them up. I was depressed. Guys, when I landed in Sydney, Australia, I opened my phone and the first message I saw was from my brother. I saw a picture of cash, $9,800 stacked up, and he had the word S-O-L-D all in caps, and the car was sold. He negotiated him $200 off, which wasn't bad, and I profited $3,000 in a matter of literally 1 week. It was unbelievable. When that happened, a spark shot in my head, and I knew there was money to be made, and that's when I started flipping cars. Even though the first car I flipped, I really didn't want to sell it. Now remember, if you're enjoying this video, don't forget to hit the like button. And right now, I'm gonna share with you 5 steps on what you can do to get into flipping cars. The first tip that I have for you all is pick the type of car you wanna flip and learn it in and out. What this means is, for example, you wanna flip a specific model, a specific car. Learn it in and out, that specific car. Not because that's the only one you're gonna flip, but because if you see it, you instantly know if it's good price, if there's money to be made, and what kind of problems it'll have. What I did is I specialized in Infiniti G35s, Infiniti G37s, and BMW 335i's. I used to buy those and sell those so much because I personally love them. Instantly when I saw them, I knew what could be wrong and what had to be done. So what I'm giving you as a tip, Find a car that you like, that you know real well, and try to keep on searching for those to flip. Number two, research the value of the cars you're trying to flip. Now, you don't need a license for this. You just go online and search the car. For example, 2002 Honda Civic. Just type that in and search. See that the majority of them might be selling for $2,500 to $3,500. What does that mean? That means that you need to get it for $1,500 to $2,000 so you can have some margin to make some profit. Research the cars before you buy them and don't just assume that it's gonna make money. See the demand, see how much they're selling for, and see if they're selling quick. Tip number three is make it convenient for the sellers. What this means is tell them, I got cash, I'm showing up right now, I'm gonna buy it on the spot if I like it. Don't haggle, don't negotiate, don't call them on the phone and start throwing numbers. Let them feel good before they meet you, because if you try to negotiate beforehand, they're already gonna be pissed off and not really like you. Compliment the car, talk good about it, and then flip it. Once you show up, kind of be nitpicky and start showing things that you don't like, show things that might be problems, and then start trying to reduce the price. But in the beginning, be cool with the seller, make it convenient for them, and let them know you're coming that moment to pay cash and buy the car. You're not coming to just tire kick. Tip number four is make it convenient for the buyers. Like I said, number three was for the sellers, number four is for the buyers. When someone's coming to buy the car, vacuum it, clean it, top off all the fluids, change the tires if they need to. Do the things that you need to do that a normal person who thinks they might be big problems sees done already. An alignment. Let them know that you did all the basics if your profit permits. Sometimes you don't even have to do that. I've bought cars literally the same day I bought them. The next day I sold them, doing absolutely nothing, made $2,000, $3,000, if not $4,000 profit. So you don't have to do that, but making the buyer see that it's so convenient and it's ready to go is a big selling point for many of the people who are buying cars. List it online and keep renewing it, and don't forget it after you post it. Stay on top of it. Tip number five is list it on all the platforms, everywhere. Craigslist, 5 Miles, OfferUp, Facebook, everywhere you could possibly think of, car gurus, wherever else you have to go, list it. And sometimes you might have to pay $20, $30, for example, cars.com and those places. You have to pay a fee, Auto Trader, but do it and then keep on renewing the listing. And when you post the listing, have nice pictures, detailed description, and don't try to hide anything from anybody. Be very blunt and make the things happen. List it online, and that's how you're gonna be smart with your sales. Bonus tip number six is be trustworthy, be honest, and don't be a crook. Don't try to make a couple bucks off of someone who's struggling, who likes the car, who you're hiding that there's a bad engine or a bad transmission. Be very clean, because God's watching, and you don't want to do someone dirty, because making that extra $200, $300, even $1,000, even $1,000,000 is never worth it. This is a bonus tip. I've actually got referrals from people who bought the cars that I flipped to them because they love the cars that I sold. Be honest with your business, and that's how you're gonna grow. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching the video. Comment below and go make some money flipping cars. I'm out. Peace.